Hello, everybody. It's me, that guy. That guy who also didn't know what to watch the Game Awards last night. I had a headache, and I was quite frankly not in the mood to do what. I went to sleep instead. There was so many everybody else is doing it, and I opted in to avoid it, really. So, you know, hey. But let's talk about the Game Awards, because I've been informed about it post here, and, you know, you want my opinion on it, right? Well, first of all, let's talk about Bill Clinton. So, everybody woke me up with, Joel, Bill Clinton was at the Game Awards. I'm like, what? Clinton in the gaming years? But apparently some clown, like, had jumped on stage when Elden Ring won, and he went,
I'd like to nominate Bill Clinton. Good night.
And security came in and cracked his head open. I don't know what the fuck that was all about. But I gotta say, why was nobody like, hey, who's that? Who's that on stage? I mean, it's ridiculous, sure, but, like, imagine if it was, like, something really crazy went down. Like, security should have, like, immediately been like, hey, get that guy, you know? Like, I don't know, man. I didn't watch it. I just heard, like, it was ridiculous what happened. But, you know, hey, the Gaming Awards, as I said, I quite don't want to watch them because, in my honest opinion, the Game Awards show, nobody watches them because, like, they're good. You want to watch them because they're, like, a circus, right? The problem with them is that they're, like, a mix of, like, overtly commercial fake crap mixed in with, like, sincerity. And it becomes, like, really awkward when, like, someone is out on stage saying, oh, thank you so much for this award. I mean, my God, I put my entire, like, free time into this, and wow, thank you so much. Yeah. And afterwards, like, and now Skrillex. Salsa on my balls, boys. Sweet rally. Peggle 2! You know, it's sponsored by Don't Vape. You know, it becomes too much. And at times, it's not even funny bad. It becomes, like, genuinely hard to watch because it's so boring. But, you know, you had your choice of streamer. Some people wanted me to do it. I opted in to not do it. So I'm sorry if you were expecting a stream last night. But, hey, you know, plenty of people did it otherwise. But, listen, let's cut to the important stuff. Let's talk about the important stuff here, which is the game announcements. Ladies and gentlemen, Tekken 8 and goddamn Armored Core. I've joked on E3, it's like, where's Armored Core? Ha ha ha. Because the joke is that nobody gives a flying fuck about Armored Core anymore. But that was my first From Software game. I still have Armored Core 2, another age here somewhere. I love Armored Core. But, you know, I remember when Dark Souls got really popular and people were like, it's from this studio so nobody heard of. I'm like, I know those guys, that's From Software, you know, the robot game, you know. But, you know, I'm excited. I haven't seen the trailer for Tekken 8. I have not seen the trailer for Armored Core 6. So, you know, I'm curious. But you want me to watch this, right? I will do so. So, let's begin the stream here with a little bit of Game Award stuff. I don't have... Well, again, I haven't seen any of these trailers. I just know about that ridiculous thing that happened with, you know, some dude thanking Bill Clinton for being a gamer or whatever. Like, I'm drinking tea, by the way. How angry do you think Jeff Keighley was when that happened? Because I haven't seen this response, but I'm going to guess that he was, like, boiling inside. He's like, how dare he show up to my video game Olympics and destroy my event? He was pissed. I would have been angry, too, because, you know, the guy's accepting the Elden Ring Awards. Like, you know, speaking of clownery, remember when Kanye West took Taylor Swift's award and said, "Yo, I'm gonna let you finish, but blah 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 blah," and it made like her award. Like, people don't remember the award, but remember, like, the bullshit-isms. You know, a lot of crazy stuff going on, you know, I don't know. But anyway, ladies and gentlemen, let's not talk about the negatives of this. We want to talk about the positives, which is the games. That's why I watch the Game Awards. I want to see the goddamn games. I don't want to see a bunch of, like, musical acts where Miyamoto goes on stage and does the Running Man. Go Mario, go Mario, Mario, Mario. Yeah. Maybe I would watch that. But listen, first of all, I want to see the Armored Core trailer here. Here it is. No PlayStation? PlayStation. Okay. I'm surprised that they don't immediately suffer from software. You know why they didn't do that? Because they know that if they do that, the Souls fans is gonna lose it, because they want the same old slop TM, right? Not to say that those games are bad, but they want a certain je ne sais quoi to it, right? They want to be like, oh my god, oh, it's a robot game. What is this? You know how? Sorry, calling it a robot game. It's a mech game. You know.
In the first age, Bill Gates formed Microsoft. Now, in the future year of 2000, you will defeat Bill Gates. You will defeat Bill Clinton at the Game Awards.
Sick trailer, though. Now, each Armored Core game is pretty much in its own universe, so, you know, all the bets are off. Maybe we'll see Nine Ball up here or whatever, because, you know, usually it, you know, it's references and stuff, but...
Feed the fire.
The sun is a deadly laser. Okay, I remember that sick Armored Core 2 Another Age opening. Yeah. Were they pulling on the cinders just to tease people a little bit? Oh, that synth. Mamma mia. And that is exactly when everybody starts pretending they knew Armored Core. Okay, I'm not saying, like, I'm a gatekeeping, you know, like, this was my game. But come on. Come on. I have never seen such enthusiasm for the series as I've seen now. Like, where the fuck were all these people? You know, like, oh my god, Armored Core is back. I'm like, you were in the same room as me? I didn't know we both liked this. I'm saying, I didn't even know this series, like, had so many fans. I liked the series a lot. But last night, everybody was, like, crying their eyes out at this. I'm like, really? Armored Core? This series? I like it. I really like two, but what the hell, you know? So we got the sword mechanic, all the classics. Now the immediate question is, are they gonna put the moonlight blade in and the Kurosawa laser? That's what's important, right? Maybe they'll put in Human Plus. Overboost is in, maybe. One day I need to play all of Armored Core 2 Another Age for you guys. I love that ending finale when you're playing against Project Phantasma and Ultimate Nineball and all that. It's a pretty good trailer, though. It's a pretty cool trailer. And the soundtrack is pretty damn cool too.
The fires of Rubicon.
OK. Okay, well, looks pretty damn sick here. That's pretty damn sick here. Wow. I don't know what else to say about this trailer except I'm pretty damn excited. Those synthesizers coming in here. You know, I think the soundtrack of Armored Core is really underrated. You have that like drum and bass breakbeat for Nineball. I really like it. So I'd love to hear what the soundtrack is going to be like, especially if it's going to be more like synthwave-esque, you know, like this. But you know, exciting stuff. I'm really stoked for this. And you know, I heard rumors about Armored Core 6 being in development a while ago, because From Software was like handing out surveys for people saying, are you guys interested? And people are like, yes, you know, in Japan. But I also voiced a concern where, you know, I don't want to sound like an annoying shithead about this, but when you're Metallica and you just released the Black Album, you're going to keep releasing the Black Album, if that makes any sense. From Software experimented with Sekiro, for example, changing it up a little bit. But for them to return to Armored Core almost seems like, I wouldn't say commercial suicide, but like, you know, the Souls fans might not want this. But then again, in the surveys, they said, you know, there might be Souls elements to this, which is going to be intriguing. But you know what? You know what? I fucking love From Software, because you know what? They encompass a old school gameplay mindset to their games, where they really have, this sounds ridiculous to say, but it really has that like Japanese mindset about video games, where there's not a lot of fluff to it. It's just solid gameplay that keeps you coming back to it, you know. And for them to return to the series and maybe introduce a new set of fans to the series, that'd be great, you know. So I'm excited to see this. I'm just perplexed why they didn't just call it Armored Core. Because, you know, you have Last Raven, you have Silent Line, you have all these games. And at this point, just fucking reboot it. You know, for the new people that don't know the series. And then just call it Armored Core 2, 3, you know. But I didn't really like Armored Core 5 that much. Verdict Day, I played it, and it was just kind of blah. I didn't play too much of Chrome Hounds either. It was a lot of these 360 mech games. But, you know, hey, excited to see a new Armored Core, man. Badass. They didn't just say that every Armored Core is in a different universe. Yeah, that's true, but I'm also saying, like, numbers intimidate people sometimes, and them seeing Armored Core 6, they're like, what is this series, you know? Now, I'm no market analyst here. I don't know what would sell the most. I'm just happy there's a new Armored Core, really. Not all of them are in different universes. That is true. You have Armored Core, I mean, To Another Age is in the same, even though it's like many, many years apart. 1, 2, and 3 is all in the same. And not 1, 2, 3. I'm talking about Master of Arena, Project Phantasm, and the original. Yes. What is the best one to start with? That's a hard question. I enjoyed Marvel Core 4. I had a lot of fun with that. In fact, it was my first interaction with foreign gamers. Fun story about this. I was playing on the 360, and I must have been 12 or 13, I think. And I had a very strenuous grasp on the English language, and I played Armored Core 4, and I had my mic on, and I was very, very afraid to talk and communicate with people. And you know what my first people I communicate online on that game is with? Japanese people. And here's a funny story. They're doing swords only deathmatch. They just had a match. I go in there and I go, "Hello, do you like robot?" And the guy said something, and they all disconnected. It scared them away. They're like, "Oh God, what is this now?" So that I have a memory of that happening. Are the games connected? Some are, but they're very different. They're very different, not in terms of gameplay, but setting. It's like their own contained universes and timelines. But Armored Core here, badass. exciting. I'm actually very excited for this. It's like Gundam. It is not like Gundam because there's not a giant. It's not a giant Gundam that has a boat for a genital. Okay, so no, it's not like Gundam at all. Stop it. Gundam boat. Okay, maybe I misremembered this. I was thinking of Oseberg. Not the same guy. Who am I thinking about? Am I thinking about the windmill? The windmill. No, I'm not thinking of this guy either. No, goddammit. You know, Gundam seems a lot more silly than I thought. I swear to God, there's like a Gundam that has like okay, now it's just getting ridiculous here. Okay, listen. we're gonna stop talking about Gundam and Armored Core. But you know, hey, very cool. I'm pretty stoked to see where this goes. And for the rest of you three fans in the world watching this trailer for Armored Core, we're gonna band together, okay? And we're gonna buy this game, and from software be like, yes, Joey, Bilbo, Terry, and Tequila Johnson have now bought our product. No gameplay, not buying. Well, let me tell you something. Welcome to Game Award Show. There's no gameplay ever. Okay, well, anyway, exciting stuff. Exciting stuff. Isn't it so much nicer the day after, guys? You know what I mean? Isn't it so fucking more nice this way? Where we don't have to sit through a bunch of celebrity cameos. We can just sit there and watch the fucking trailer at our own pace with no shit in between. Fuck. But anyway, I know there's a new Mario Brothers trailer, but I kind of don't want to see it, because, well, to be quite honest, I just want to see the movie. Right? The more I see the trailers, the more, like, oh, come on, you know, I'm fine, I watched what I watched, so it's just a clip of the movie. Apparently, Al Pacino was at the Game Awards show, by the way. Dunkachino. What game was he promoting? What game was he promoting? He gave an award for what? He was presenting the first award for not for what? The Dunkachino Awards. Best performance. Yeah, but that, he might have, Al Pacino giving out an award, it's like Tiger Woods handing out a paper cutout of a mini golf club at a putt-putt for kids.
Here you go.
You know, fuck. He did that. Okay, so, but who won the best award? Who won the best award? Weirdest flex. The Kratos guy. I don't know why. It's just, I don't know why. You know, I bought the PlayStation 4, and I never played the God of War game. And ironically, I bought my dad a PlayStation 5 for his birthday, and all he wants to do is play hockey every day, you know, give or take. But I have never checked out those God of War games. I saw a friend of mine play PlayStation 3 God of War, whatever, and they look like good beat 'em up American Devil May Cry games, and I'm not talking about DMC, the American Devil May Cry game. They look pretty good. They look pretty good, but sorry, I just got to drink my tea here. Anyway, what was I saying? Yes, I was saying that the... I probably should put a picture on screen as I'm talking about this, by the way. It's been 20 minutes already, and I'm just talking shit here. Hang on. What is a good image of Kratos? There we go. It's appropriate. Anyway, I never really played these games, so I can't really like say if they're good or not. But is this new game like the old ones, where you go around and you go, you know, six smoking style moves? No, not at all. No, 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 not really. Combat is very different. No, they are boring and different now. They're full of cutscenes. Okay. It's like a playable movie. But does it make you feel like the God of War? I feel there's like two games that have completely escaped my realm of interest. I just like have no fucking clue about them. It's the PlayStation Spider-Man games and the God of War games. It's like these two juggernauts of gaming. Everybody's like, they are the best. But I've never heard anybody like really sit down and play them. You know? Like, do you know what I'm talking about? Like, oh, Spider-Man and God of War. It's like, really? I did, Yuel. Okay, Spider-Man was fine. I'm gonna get some shit for saying this. I thought that Spider-Man PlayStation 4 game, I thought it was okay, but it started getting a little boring. I don't know. I thought that, I don't know. I guess I don't like Spider-Man, but guys, don't tell Spider-Man I said that. Don't tell Spider-Man I said that. I'm begging you, don't tell Spider-Man. Don't tell please do not tell Spider-Man. I played very little at Spider-Man games. Like, I couldn't really tell you if it gets better. I just played a little bit of it at the beginning, you know. But listen, whatever. Congratulations on the God of War dude for, you know, saying all that English that I have no idea what he's saying in the game because I didn't play it. And, you know, I know Elden Ring won the Game of the Year award, a one-off game I played once and I did not follow up on, but... You know, maybe now let's calm down a little bit. Now we'll play it, right? You know. So there's that. Now, moving on, we have another thing I want to check out here. Something that is also, again, relevant to my interest. It's Tekken 8.
Peggy 16.
Okay. I gotta be honest. Now, you don't want me to pause this and say my opinion, but... Or do you? I don't know. I feel Tekken has gone down the god-killing route, where the game starts feeling like Azura's Wrath. The last game, you had Akuma show up from Street Fighter, now canon within this universe. And you're kind of like, you're getting so powerful now that unless Jin and Kazuya is punching the sun, this is not going to be very, you know... Like, now this has to... Because, like, where do you... Because every game is getting bigger and more explosive and crazy. It's like Dragon Ball Z, where death will eventually stop meaning nothing, you know? Start meaning nothing, really, but... I don't know, but let's just keep watching. She was really annoying to play against in Tekken Tag 2, I remember that, too. Jin. Okay, first of all, is that Law? Is that Paul? Yeah, it's Paul, but Paul, what happened to your haircut? Jesus Christ, you're like a 50-year-old dad trying to look like you're 20 again. Paul, for fuck's sake, you ain't fooling nobody, you're old. Right? You lost your hair gel. Okay. Okay. You ever try that thing where you try to make yourself like pass out? It's when you squat, you go up and you hold your breath or whatever and go. Eventually you see stars and you. Right, it's like really bad to do. I never tried it, but it's like some technique to like actually pass out or something. That's that face. Yeah. This is me as a kid going shopping with mom, and there's no bathrooms around, and I just have to like hold in a poo, okay? And my mom's like, "We'll be home soon." I'm just like. There's Jack, there's King. Music is very Tekken, I gotta say. Okay, I just gotta say it. All the characters in Tekken speak their native language. Except this chuckle fuck from Sweden called Lars. This guy is not speaking Swedish. What in the goddamn fuck is that? Okay, yeah. It's like Overwatch. You have all these people who are like, you know, respectfully voice act by actors from their native countries. And then you have Torbjorn. Yarr! We gotta capture the flag and get me golden booty! Yarr, me be Thorbjorn! What the fuck? Yarr! What the hell is that? Okay, well, anyway. Sounds just like you. What the hell? Anyway, go on. I don't know why, but the no signal thing reminds me of something I saw at the grocery store a couple days ago. I love when you go into like malls and one of the HDMI outputs is just someone's like Windows 10 and it's just like update Windows now. Like you're at the grocery store and one of the monitors just fuck out and it's just like Facebook or something. You see what I mean? Like it's getting so out of hand now. I mean, there's always been the Jin Kazuya thing in Heihachi, but dude, like, obviously, I only care about Brian, but you know, hey, fist meets fate. Okay, that's a weird way of putting it. Fist meets fate.
Peggy 16.
I'm a performance artist. Fisting is $300. I turned my house into a dungeon. So I'm drinking tea here, guys. I'm drinking tea here. That looks pretty cool. That looks pretty cool. But you know what I really like about this trailer? Because it's gameplay. It's gameplay and Joey likes gameplay, okay? So, you know. Tea, it is tea. It's tea. It's celestial seasonings, Bengal spice infusion, and there's a tiger on it, and it's pretty good. I've been eating Indian stuff all day. I ordered a Rogan Josh for my food today, and then I'm having tea later. So, yes, hello, hello, India. Josh Rogan, pull it up. Anyway, pretty damn cool trailer, as I said. Cool games. Now, yeah, absolutely. I like it. There's also a Street Fighter 6 trailer. Can you guys link me up to that real quick? I kind of forgot about that real quick. Have you seen the Mario Brothers movie clip? I'm not gonna watch it. I just want to watch the damn movie. Okay. Somebody, instead of giving me the trailer to Street Fighter, they are now linking me up to Gorilla Flashdance in Pool. Okay, guys, this is why I can't accept links anymore, because you guys are being ridiculous. What is this? Okay. Hey, hang on. Slow down, chief. Okay. Guys, is it bad that the third most exciting game here we have to show on the Joel Game Awards is a Gorilla Flashdance in the pool? Okay. Now, Armored Core fans, I got a trailer for you here. It's Gorilla Dancing in the Sun. Yeah, you baiting that uranium. Man.
Feed the fire. Let the cinders burn. Bravo, George Lucas! Bravo, Jorge! You have done another Star Wars!
timing! Okay. Stop it. Okay. Here's a Street Fighter 6 trailer. Okay, thank you. It's an official trailer. Let me just get this downloaded. Alright. I'm sorry for like all the Dwarf Fortress fans that are like, you know, I'm here for like games, not this like monkey business. Okay, here we go. Here's Street Fighter 6. Come on. You remember that Tekken trailer? Fist meets ass. Well, if you told me this was an EA trailer for like Sims Dance Club expansion, I would have fucking believed you. Okay. Ubisoft presents. Oh, I got Hagar. What is happening? I'm so- what? What is happening? What, this game looks like a fucking Unity fighting game. What is this? What the hell is this? What are these characters? Lady Gaga? Okay.
He was obsessed, you see, with finding an appropriate vessel for this bomb.
No, it's Joseph. What is this guy?
Showtime, baby!
Okay, hang on. Didn't you win an award for being the best by Al Pacino? No, I think God the well.
An honor, to be sure.
Well, I have my English game set to EN for English. Please, I don't understand. Maybe it's just I have a blurry upload, but my god, I don't usually whine about the graphics, but this game looks like a Xbox 360 arcade game. Maybe just because it's very blurry, but this looks like... Okay, so some shots certainly look way better. See, I saw so much of the Mortal Kombat 11 fatalities that, like, I'm just sitting here nervously waiting, like, a skull to be turned into soup and some spine being shat out by someone's asshole. Like, I'm sitting here like, oh god, what is the gore gonna begin? You put Dudley in. Can I say this too? I mean, this looks pretty cool to play, but what happens to all these new characters that are introduced in a new Street Fighter game and they're forgotten about and they never return? Like, what about that oil guy from Street Fighter 4? They die. They're dead. Yeah, well, you know. They should do what they did with Smash, okay? Everything that's ever been in, put it in. I guess, except Ice Climbers, but hey, you know, everyone is here, you know. I don't know, there's a Hakan reference in Street Fighter 6. Hakan is like the Dunsparce of Street Fighter, okay? Everybody just remembers him because he's like so... What? What is that? It's a guy that oils himself up and slips around. He's Dunsparce, you know? Did we have a fist on the North Star thing just now? Ah, neat. Okay. Okay, for a second there, I thought that Street Fighter... Okay, did anybody else feel this? When they did this... Right around after this shot, when they went to USA here in Metro City, right here, I thought they were doing a parody. I thought they were like doing what they did in the Oscars in the 2000s. We're like, we're gonna do a Matrix parody. I thought they were trying to be like, yeah, we made a fake game here to represent, like, and then the real thing begins, you know, like, you know, you have Billy Crystal here fighting or something, you know, because this looked so like... What is this? Honestly, the longer I look, the funnier it gets. The guy on the right and the guy on the left. These aren't new characters, are they? But these are like custom characters. That's why they look so bland, right? Could you imagine? Could you imagine if this guy is the new... He looks like he works at, like, Best Buy. Like Best Buy Jimmy. He has no story. He's a good retail worker. Jimmy S tier. It looks like a rev or something. Geek Squad. Oh my God. What about the spectator here in the background, you know? Oh my God. All right. Well, Street Fighter 6 looks cool. Neat. We have one more thing to check out, by the way. We have one more thing to check out here. But my game awards here, or my reactions to it, is about to be over. So, you know, here we go. What is the last thing that I'm interested for? Well, I'll show you.
Donkey Kong is back. Check out the new Donkey Kong for the Nintendo 2. Maximum gameplay, maximum monkey.
Okay, no, I have an actual thing for you. This. Ladies and gentlemen, this was announced last night. Now, I wasn't there for it, but I can tell you one thing. If I was, I would have jumped up and down. I would have had a demonic, epileptic exorcism live on stream, because this game just refuses to go down in popularity. And the more people whine about this game's popularity, the stronger it gets, okay? I love this, like, rock.mp3. It's like MIDI. Now look at this. Oh, there's a new game mode. That's what this is. I had no idea what this was. There was just something about Among Us, really. But is this like hide and seek? What is this? Like you just gotta avoid the monster? This seems kind of fun, actually. See, you know, fun is often most rooted in simplicity. And the more complex you make things, the more it's like, I don't know. But just having like run from the guy could be very, very fun. Because some of my favorite multiplayer stuff... Oh, they can pet the dog. Oh, no. some of my most favorite gameplay moments in multiplayer. I don't know if anybody's played this. Most likely. But when I was growing up, I used to play Counter-Strike Source. And there used to be zombie escape mods. And these zombie escape mods were fucking fun as hell. There was like 30 people on a server. One zombie spawned. And when he tagged another player, they turned into a zombie. And the objective of the map was to like run across a very large span of a level to a helicopter, right? And this helicopter was waiting. And eventually, it's like you had 2 minutes to get to the helicopter, like 20 minutes or whatever. And then the helicopter would take off. And as you run to the helicopter, some players would be left behind. And you'd laugh at them as they'd be left behind on the island being devoured by zombies. Like, ha ha ha, suckers. You know, like you're fucking up for the other players. This is great. You know, and I'm saying just a simple concept of run from the crazies. You know, like that's super fun. You know, but maybe you should play Counter-Strike Zombie Escape one of these days, dude. I don't think I've ever laughed this hard when, like, those servers also, like, had a flashbang or something like that that let you push other people's, other players off. And I remember how angry people would get when they were, like, on a skyscraper trying to go across a tightrope, and you go, whoop, and they just go, whoop! And then you just met me. but yeah, maybe that one of these days. But this looks fun. This looks very fun. I rather enjoy this. I rather enjoy Among Us because it's a very simple game, and it's like it depends how creative you are with your killing. You know, if you can like also go on microphone with friends, it's really fun. if you're playing with complete strangers, it might not be as fun. But you know, it's all these. It's very like much like TTT. You know, it's very simple. Like, you know, but yeah, cool. Everybody. That's the game awards. I cut out all the fat, and I'm excited for Armored Core. I'm excited for Tekken. Excited for the new Among Us thing. I know Hades 2 was announced, and I know like there's a new Bayonetta game. There's also like something else. Death Stranding 2, Joel. Ah. It's a Mario movie clip. You know, it was a funny animal fighting game, really. Well, okay, cool. Neat. There's a new Crash Bandicoot as well. Well, all these things sound mildly interesting to me. I figured I would only showcase the highlights from this because, you know, you want me to play games that I'm actually interested in, right? But yeah, you know. So big shout outs to Al Pacino.
Big shout outs to Bill Clinton for being the best gamer.
And of course, you know, till next year, Jeff Keighley. Maybe next year I will watch your show and not opt in to take a big sleep instead. So, I don't know. But yeah, my word chat, next E3, if I'm not like sick with a flu or something, I will stream it. You know, I feel the Game Awards shows, they just, you know. But the E3 thing, I have to commit to because, guys, we are gamers, hashtag. We are hashtag gamers. And it's our obligation to the human race to watch commercials for 4 or 5 days and then pretend that we all cared about it when we can't remember the last year's event. See you next year on the Game Awards show. And don't forget, don't vape.
Okay, Bowser?
Let me interrupt the nice music with some bad music instead. Yeah.
planted in the warning center from the grave for the bastards.
Coffin Bastards. A song that is very much Motorhead. Oof. What a bunch of shit. You guys want to listen to Skeleton War? You know what? Just wait for the album.